Thank you. 9 billion and you. Let's start with me. I'm madly crazy about nature. I walk around when I was young and being busy with my chicken all the time. I was amazed bringing my leftovers to the garden. Then the chicken ate it. And in the compost, there were all insects living. And that's me. But what you should know about me and extra, I'm when people say to me, it's impossible, I go to run. And when they say, it's really impossible, and they laugh me in the face, I even run harder. And what I love here in that nature, the simplicity, it's the speed of growth, and it's also the way the simple system works. And this is where I want to talk with you about today. My talk is about insects, and insects as food. Yes, insects as food. Nobody ever thought about that. And my lecture today, my talk today, is really about having why insects, and then I want to tell you a bit more about insects as food, nutritious food, and then I go deeper into building businesses. Here I am. We are facing something here. It's now 9 billion. And, sorry, it's now 7 billion, and 1 billion is underfed here in this world, and 1 billion is obese. And there we are. Obese and welfare are going together. That's a golden rule. When you eat, when you are wealthy, and you are there is more welfare, your food consumption is more going to meat. And look in the restaurants. On the menu in the restaurants, it's all built. Beef, take fish, take something like shrimps. It's also an insect-like thing, but it's not vegetables what's on the dish. And there's the other part. When the world population is growing, also, our amount of waste is really, really growing. Our meat consumption, the other thing is that it's for 70% now, it's taking the land use, where we can have also cereals to bake our bread. But it's also there that our meat consumption, they're even worse for the environment, for the greenhouse gases, even more than our cars. And then there is the other thing. The population in China is growing. China was a soy importer a decade ago. Now China is a soy importer. It was an exporter. We, for our pigs here in the Netherlands, we imported soy from China. And then something more about insects. It doesn't go. Oh, there it is. Ah, some fixtures. Because these insects are not only our friends, they're also our enemies. They bring diseases. They bring diseases like malaria. There is also the Lyme disease. It's a pest, but they're also useful. In our agricultural system, we always have insects in. Needed because for pollination, but I'll take you to some figures. Here, a 15 billion desert locust in one swarm. And these are the woestijn sprinkhanen. Per square kilometer of land, there's 10 billion insects. Per insect per person is estimated on 2 million. And then there is species of insects, and that's all 6 million, and described in literature, there are a million. But species edible, there we count down, it's about 1900. And in the Netherlands, there's the trick, we can farm them. And I took my little farm with me here. And it's only 62 species that are farmed here, and species that are allowed by law to farm. And that's the welfare law says it's 29. So there's some illegal business. But for fun today, I made a little multiplication. Let's say we are here with 9 billion people here in this world. We live here, and we multiply that 9 billion with 2 million insects per person, then you have nearly a 2 with 18 zeros behind it. So that will be our population of insects in 2050. That's quite a lot. These animals here, they're short-cycled mini-livestock, that's called them, they call them this way. And the system is simple. They lay their eggs in short time, become a larvae or a maggot, then a pupae, and then, in the end, they metamorphose into a beetle. Short-cycled mini-livestock. These animals here, I took mealworms, take 10 weeks to become, when you can harvest them. A housefly, what you have in your bin, only takes 5 days. So when you put your waste in that, we can do a lot of it with it. And there's the question, what can we do with it? Shall we use it as feed, food for animals? Or do we use them as food for us to bake bread out of it? 10 kilos of feed is good for 3 kilo of chicken, and then there is the rest of the skins and things like that. It's good for 5 kilo of chicken, but 8 kilos of cricket. And that brings good business, because when you count a bit, you can do a lot. And especially when you know they are our waste converters. Here we are. This is what my simple design is. Nature taught me. And this is what I saw when I was young with my chicken, seeing them eating the insects. We have our organic waste. We know in future the organic waste pile is really, really going, becoming bigger and bigger. We turn them into maggots. And these are really nutritious. It's essential amino acids. There is unsaturated fatty acids in it. And then there is the chitin part of it. We can simply grind them and use it as use it in feed, but we can also use it in for ourselves to have it in our meatballs, extra meat replacer. And I really doubt it if vegetarians would eat it, because a lot of them I meet really like to eat it because they think it's a sustainable solution. It's only the way why you're vegetarian. There is another thing. Chicken became, from one day in the other, when the BSE crisis, the TSE crisis, they became vegetarian. And afterwards, chicken lost their natural food. It was really like from one day in the other. And the other thing what happened then was that their health decreased, really decreased, and antibiotics came in this industry, this farming. On the other hand, we've heard it today, there is the fish consumption. And nowadays, the policy is that fish is coming, farmed fish is becoming more and more a sustainable way of eating fish, but also it is promoted by all our governments. In the end, we have there, again, in our circular vision, that the waste out of it can be weird. We consume it and then we bring it again to the insects as bioconverter. Here is our industry we see. It's the same story I just told you, but it is organic waste. Then we put them in large-scale bioconversion. They convert it. Normally nowadays, they are grown here in the Netherlands. It's 16 farms we have. And we bring them as special pet food to reptiles or zoos. But the main, and we have them as food already. That's a small business, I come later to this. But the biorefinery, that's really the part where we can do it. So in this way, we can close the whole nutrient loop. And this is where I really like to talk to you, because that's why I took my whole mealworm farm here. It is about a controlled production environment. People ask always, they think, do we have to take them from our bin? No, we don't do that. I have here and I think the camera will come and I'll show you, because here we have our beetles. They're in here, laying their eggs in this. That's the simple production system here. And then we sieve it. And then the animals will be in here, in this box, for 10 weeks. You see them in here. Questions about animal welfare always is, for a cow, we fought for years. No, sorry, a pig, for years, to have a square meter to live in. These animals normally live right upon each other. You don't see them because they don't like the light. They're light shy. And they stay in here for 10 weeks. And here you see, the camera will show you. Oh, is the camera on? No. Can you put it on? Yes, here. There they are, in 10 weeks. And then we sieve them again and put them cold in. At 4 degrees, you see, they are alive in here, but they don't move. You can keep them cooked for weeks. We can stock them in this way. And then afterwards, there is a problem. We have to kill them. But in nature, always, what's always happening, it becomes winter. And during winter times, these animals die. And that's what we do. That's the only unnatural thing. We tell them when it's winter time. But I think we are worth something. We have knowledge here, what we can bring to the other side of the world. And this is one of the things I'll show you here. This is Florence here in the middle, in her little cricket farm in Kenya. Because we can farm them. For them, it's normally, it's a seasonal product they harvest. When the termite hills are coming up, for them, it's time to eat insects. And they're nutritious. These insects, and we see they're underfed and malnutrition, and these crickets can help them. And what we want to do, and we is a Dutch consortium, and TNO is involved in it, and Wageningen University. We want to establish within 4 years 4,000 farms over there. And it's really, they're enthusiastic, and they start up their own new business. Now, insects as food. I'll tell you. This is what we did. 5 years ago, we brought them here to the wholesale market. And that was the moment we could come and talk to our policymakers. John the Baptist in the Bible, he ate them. So it's not new what we did, but only we need something extra here, because we have must be allowed. And there's something in your mind that tells you, your mother already told you, don't eat insects, they're dirty. So that's what we do now. We want to make tasty products. And certainly you will taste today. And there's the question. What's the difference between a locust and a shrimp? It is family somewhere in the arthropods. We can learn from the other side of the world. 80% of world population is already eating insects. In Mexico or in Laos. Laos, the left picture, it's in Laos. And this, on the right hand, you see some cooking in the Netherlands. And it's tasty, I can tell you. Then there is the part of gastronomy coming in to teach people and educate them to eat these insects. So there we go. Insects, and there is an insect cookbook, and this is the future development. We take out the proteins, and then we make pizzas out of it. Or we use the fatty acids, the unsaturated fatty acids. We have big challenges to go, because this market isn't there yet, to bring our waste to the insects. It's not allowed. The legislators simply forgot to bring insects in legislation and regulatory things. Because when we use organic waste, and we know how much food waste there is, we can simply use it to grow these insects on. And then we are. There are the maggots. What to do with them? Some sorts are not even allowed to farm. And then there is the question. There is legislation about killing animals. How to deal with that? We all find solutions for that. And there is lots of questions coming from society. Is this animal friendly? Now, we're taking a look at that, because when it was a pest, nobody ever asked about that. How to kill an insect? No, boy, we kill them all. It's not allowed to bring them to chicken. Nowadays, luckily, the European Commission, they made an exception for fish and fish meal. But then the business case isn't a good one, because we cannot feed them on the food waste. We have to give them that good feed, what we normally also can eat. And then in the end, we come at the place of the supermarket where it has to end. And we are so lucky here. Oh, here we are. This is the vicious circle we are in. One side, because this is all handcrafted, it's still not automated, there's the cost price. Labor is a very huge cost in it. And on the other hand, there's legislation. So there are no products, there is no turnover yet, no investments, although there are farms coming up now, good farms, doing big investments in it. And we can scale the technical development. And then when there is products, there will be market demand. And we are so lucky here in the Netherlands to have a good collaboration. We have established 5 years ago the Dutch Insect Farmers Association, VENIC. That was helpful, but at that moment, our government could talk to a professional body and could make any... they could have subsidies and grants for research at Wageningen University, where we have a big program. Last week, 5 years later, a more professional organization, International Insect Center, is established. And the other thing is, we are so lucky to have the Green Deal. Our government really is committed to do lobbying and to really change the rules. That's what we need. And in the end, there is next year, no, last year, there was in May, the book of FAO, the United Nations Food and Agriculture Organization, about edible insects. First day only, it was downloaded 2.3 million times. And I invite you to download it as well, because it's available as e-book. And that's the next phase, the next stage where we're in. We do not have to prove insects are needed. And next year, all over the world, academics, but also entrepreneurs will come over to the Netherlands to have insects to feed the world, the conference over here, together with FAO. And for this moment, I really believe insects are there, and it's my recipe to feed the world. And they will become big bucks business. Thank you.